Hello everyone, welcome back to the video lecture series on digital communications. In this session, we will discuss the concept of information capacity law. So, this theorem is proposed by Sean Hartley. This theorem tells the maximum rate at which the information can be transmitted over a communication channel of a specified bandwidth in the presence of noise. It tells us the maximum rate at which the information is transmitted over a communication channel for a specified bandwidth in the presence of noise. So it describes the maximum amount of error-free transmission over a noisy channel for the particular bandwidth, right? So now we will derive the mathematical expression for channel capacity. That is, the signal is band limited, power limited, Gaussian channel. So let us consider a zero mean stationary process, that is x of t, which is band limited to BH. We are considering the signal that is band limited to BH, capital BH, right? So we are considering XK, the K value means it is varied from 1 to K. It is a continuous random variables. These are continuous random variables. If the signal is band limited to B, here X is a continuous random variables, right? So according to sampling theorem, the sampling frequency fs must be greater than or equal to 2fm, where fs is the sampling frequency, fm is the maximum frequency of the message signal. So here the signal is band limited to bh, so the minimum sampling rate required is fs equal to 2 into fm, so which is equal to 2 into b. So the minimum sampling rate is 2b for this particular signal, right? Now the signal X is transmitted over a channel. When the signal is passing through the channel, always some noise is added to it. That noise we are assuming as N. And Y is nothing but the received signal. Y is nothing but the received signal. Right? So we will derive the mathematical expression for channel capacity, that is for a band limited, power limited, Gaussian channel. Right? So we know that one, for a Gaussian channel, the probability density function P of X equal to 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square into e power minus x cube, right? 2 sigma square. We are already assumed the mean is 0. Sigma square represents the variance. Right? So look at carefully and understand the mathematical analysis. Right? The first step is you can multiply with minus log, that is it will becomes minus log of px equal to minus log of 1 by 2 pi sigma square into e power minus x square by 2 sigma square. The change here it is, we are multiplying with minus log on both sides, right? So which can be represented as log a into log b. So log a into log b is nothing but log a plus log b. So which is equal to minus log of 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square minus log of e power minus x square by 2 sigma square. Right? So here the minus term is common for both these two. Log a into log b, which is equal to log a plus log b. Right? So this can be further simplified as minus log of, so it is 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square. This can be represented as square root of 2 pi sigma square whole power minus 1. 1 by x means x inverse. Minus log of e power minus x square by 2 sigma square. So bring this minus to front side. So it will becomes minus of minus becomes plus log of square root of 2 pi sigma square. So bring this minus to front side, plus log of e power x square by 2 sigma square. So that is the first one. So what we did is simply multiply to minus log on both sides and do the mathematical simplification. Right? Now, so which is equal to minus log p of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus log of e power x square by 2 sigma square. The next one is multiply with p of x, multiply with p of x on both sides. So by multiplying with p of x, it will becomes minus p of x log p of x, which is equal to, it is p of x log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus p of x log of e power x square by 2 sigma square. So what we did is, so multiply p of x on both sides, right? The next one is, we are integrating the above equation, integrating the above equation from minus infinity to plus infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity. Why? Because we are considered as continuous channel. Integrating the above equation from minus infinity to plus infinity on both sides results minus infinity to plus infinity p of x log p of x into dx equal to minus infinity to plus infinity p of x log of square root of 2 pi sigma square into dx plus minus infinity to plus infinity p of x log of e power x square by 2 sigma square x square by 2 sigma square into dx. So, right? So, what we did is, we are integrating the above equation from minus infinity to plus infinity. Right? So, how it can be simplified? So, you can look into it carefully. If you remember the formula for entropy, which is equal to minus sigma k equal to 1 to m pk log pk. Right? So, here we are considering as continuous channel. So that is varied from minus infinity to plus infinity minus p of x log p of x into dx. So what it represents? It represents the simply h of x. So this term results simply entropy for continuous. Okay. So which is equal to, this can be further simplified as, we bring this term to right side. Please observe the steps carefully. Log of square root of 2 pi sigma square into minus infinity to plus infinity p of x dx. So I am bringing this log term front side. So minus infinity to plus infinity p of x into d of x plus, see here carefully, this can be represented as, bring this x square by 2 sigma square into the front side. So the term it becomes minus infinity to plus infinity p of x into x square by 2 sigma square into log e dx. X square by 2 sigma square, bring the x square by 2 sigma square into front side. So it becomes minus into plus infinity p of x square by 2 sigma square log e dx, right? So how to simplify the equation? So look at the equation carefully. The simplification is like this, right? So what is this term? It is minus infinity to plus infinity p of x d of x, right? So here minus infinity to plus infinity p of x into d of x, the area of the density function, which is always 1, right? Now what we are modifying is, you can look at here carefully. So bring this log E to front side, that means by simplification I am taking here, right? So the equation is h of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus log E into minus infinity to plus infinity p of x into x square by 2 sigma square d of x. Okay, so the modification is, this first term is asked is log of 2 pi sigma square plus, so bring 1 by 2 sigma square front side, so bring that 1 by 2 sigma square, this term into front side, so it will becomes 1 by 2 sigma square, so remaining term is as this log E minus infinity to plus infinity p of x into x square dx, right? So look at this term, so this term is nothing but the simply variance. This term is a print simply variance because we are already assumed the mean value is 0, right? So if we simplify it, which is equal to log of 2 pi sigma square, that is square root of 2 pi sigma square plus 1 by 2 sigma square into log E, this value is nothing but the variance, which is nothing but the sigma square. Okay, so instead of this term we are substituting as sigma square, right? So further simplification, this sigma square and this sigma square both are get cancelled, and this can be printed as log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus 1 by 2 log E, 1 by 2 log E, so which is equal to log of square root of 2 pi sigma square, log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus, so bring this 1 by 2 to here, so it will becomes log of e power 1 by 2. If you bring this 1 by 2, if you bring this 1 by 2 to here, so it will becomes e power 1 by 2, right? So which is equal to log of 2 pi sigma square, that is square root of log square root of 2 pi sigma square plus log of root E, log of root E, okay, log of root E, h of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi sigma square plus log of root E, log A plus log B, log A plus log B is nothing but log A, so which is equal to log of square root of 2 pi E sigma square, h of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi e sigma square. So the units for entropy is bits per message, right? So where sigma square is nothing but the variance, right? So this is basically, it is base 2, we remember always, okay, log of square root of 2 pi e sigma square base 2, right? So please remember this value. So while simplifying the next term, we are using this part, right? Or otherwise let it be equation number 1, okay? So we are using equation number 1 in the next session for further simplification of the channel capacity, okay, right? So consider a source transmitting information over a noisy channel, that means we are transmitting our information over a noisy channel. Right? So the received signal y equal to x plus n, where y is nothing but the received signal, x is nothing but the transmitted signal, and n is the noise. We are transmitting our information over a noisy channel. So the received signal is nothing but the transmitted signal plus some noise. Right? So we are assuming that the signal and noise both are independent. We are assuming that the signal and noise are independent. Right? Now, we want to represent the mutual information. So we are already covered in the previous classes the mutual information. So the information over a channel, it can be represented the difference of entropy, the difference of entropy of the received symbol and the noise. So we already know this formula. So that is I of x comma y equal to h of y minus h of y by x. So we are already assume the signal and the noise both are independent, right? So this can be represented as, which is equal to h of y minus h of n, h of y minus h of n. So if you remember, what is h of x? H of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi e sigma square. We are already derived. H of x equal to log of square root of 2 pi e sigma square. Right? Now, by using this one, we are going to simplify this term. Right? So, here what is y? Y is nothing but the received signal. Right? So, the average power of the received signal will be the average power of the received signal will be S plus N, where S represents the average power of the signal, N represents the average power of the noise. Here, S represents the average power of the signal, the average power of the signal, and N represents the average power of the noise. The average power of the noise. Right? Why? Because the received signal is nothing but the transmitted signal plus noise. Right? So, we are modifying these terms. Look at carefully. So, this can be simplified as, that is this term. So, we are going to simplify this term. That is h of y minus h of n. Right? I of x comma y equal to h of y can be represented as log of square root of 2 pi into s plus n. 2 pi into s plus n. That is the power of the received signal. Minus h of n. Minus h of n means the noise power. Log of square root of 2 pi into n. So we are assuming as n is nothing but the noise power. Right? So look at these two terms. It is log A minus log B. Log A minus log B is nothing but log A by B. So this can be simplified as log of square root of 2 pi into S plus N by square root of 2 pi E into N. So log A minus log B is nothing but log A by B. Right? So in this one, so we are having as the common terms are, so 2 pi and 2 pi. So the simplified equation is log of square root of numerator is S plus N and the denominator is N. So it can be simplified as log of square root of, it is S by N plus 1, because N by 1 is nothing but 1. Right? So now, which is, it is I of x comma y. So I of x comma y is nothing but the mutual information. So the units for the mutual information is bits per message. The units for mutual information is bits per message. So I of x comma y, which is equal to log of square root of s plus n plus 1. Right? Now, maximum of I of x comma y, that is the maximum mutual information, which is equal to log of square root of 1 plus s by n. Log of square root of 1 plus s by n. So the maximum of mutual information is called as the CS, which is equal to log of square root of 1 plus s by n. Right? Our aim is we want to find out what is the capacity of the Gaussian channel. What is the capacity of the Gaussian channel? So the channel capacity of the Gaussian channel, channel capacity of the Gaussian channel, so C equal to, if you remember the formula in the previous case, R into CS. Channel capacity C equal to R into CS. What is the value of R? The number of sample cities, 2 into B. CS is nothing but log of square root of 1 plus S by N. So this is the formula from the channel capacity. That means the channel capacity, here it is, we can represent in terms of bits per second. It is represented in terms of bits per second. So which is equal to 2 into B log of square root of 1 plus S by N. So bring this 2 to here. So it becomes, your equation becomes, which is equal to B into log of square root of 1 plus S by N whole power 2. If you bring this 2 to here, so it will becomes B into log of square root of 1 plus S by N whole square. Right? So which is equal to C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N. Because you can look at here. So here, this 2 and square root of get cancelled. So you can get the final equation is C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N. So that is the final equation. C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N base 2. So the units for channel capacity is bits per second. The units for channel capacity is bits per second. So here the C represents the channel capacity. B represents channel bandwidth or bandwidth of the channel, and S represents the power of the signal, that is average power of the signal, that is input signal. Okay, and N represents, so what are the conclusion statements from the channel capacity, right? The first one is, if the signal to noise ratio, that is S1 value, if SNR value is increases, if SNR value is increases, automatically the capacity of the channel is also increases. C is also increases. So if you substitute S by N equal to 1, its value is some x, let us say S by N value is further increased, it is y. That means if S by N value is increases, automatically channel capacity also increases. That's the first conclusion statement. The second one is, if B increases, B means the bandwidth of the channel increases, which results the channel capacity is also increases. That means the channel capacity is increased by increasing either bandwidth or S by N band. Okay. Noiseless channel. What is the meaning of noiseless channel? Noiseless channel means that is N value equal to 0. N value is 0. Right. So when N becomes 0, S by N equal to infinity. If you substitute N value, so which is equal to infinity. Right. So when the signal to noise ratio is infinity, the channel capacity is also infinity. Okay. That is the first statement. So noiseless channel has infinity capacity. Right. So that is the first one. Second one is infinity bandwidth channel has limited capacity. So the meaning of the statement is if B equal to infinity, that is infinity bandwidth channel, it has limited capacity. Okay, so we want to prove mathematically. So if the bandwidth is infinity, the capacity is limited. Because when the bandwidth of the channel is increases, the noise power is also increases. Right? So we know the formula. C equal to B log of 1 plus S by N, it is base 2. C equal to B log of 1 plus S by N base 2, right? So here the bandwidth of the channel is increases. The meaning of the statement is the noise power N equal to some N0 into B. The noise power is also increases. So N equal to N0 into B, where B is nothing but the bandwidth of channel, and N0 is, N0 represents power spectral SD, PSD of AWGN channel, additive white Gaussian noise channel. N0 represents the power spectral density of AWGN channel. Right? So substitute this term here. C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N. Instead of N, I am substituting as N0 into B. Instead of N, I am substituting as N0 into B. Right? So, how it can be simplified? How it can be simplified? So, C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N0 into B. Okay, so this can be simplified as B into, this can be simplified as B into, I am doing with simply small changes, N0 by S into S by N0. So these two terms get cancelled, you can get only one, right? So into log of 1 plus S by N0 into, okay? So the only change in this step is we are multiplying and dividing, that is N0 by S into S by N0. If these two terms get cancelled, you can get the previous equation as it is, right? Now can be simplified as S by N0, it is as it is, that means this term is as it is, and the remaining term, what is the remaining term? It is N0 into B by S. Okay, so this value is, I am taking to here, so it is 1 plus S by N0 into B, and this term, it is N0 into B by S, that indicates, so this term, that is B into N0 by S, So this value is brings into here. Okay. So S by N naught log of 1 plus S by N naught into B whole power N naught B by S. So this can be simplified as, so by considering a simple mathematical equation. So which is limit x tends to 0 1 plus x whole power 1 by x. So what is the value? So its value is e limit x tends to 0 1 plus x whole power 1 by x equal to e, right? So now here in this case I am assuming as this value is nothing but x. So automatically this term is 1 by x. So x value is s by n naught into b. So 1 by x becomes n naught into b by s, right? That indicates this total value, that is this part. You can check it here clearly. So that is 1 plus x whole power 1 by x. Its value is e. How its value is e? Right? So here we are assumed as x equal to s by n naught into b. X value we are considering here is s by n naught into b. Right? So when b means bandwidth, when bandwidth approaches to infinity, which implies x approaches to 0. Here s value is constant, n naught is also some constant, right? When b, that is bandwidth of the channel, approaches to infinity, x value approaches to 0. That indicates limit x tends to 0 1 plus x whole power 1 by x equal to e, right? So that means, so this total value is nothing but e. So it can be simplified as s by n naught into log e, that is based s by n naught into log e based. Okay, so you can use the calculator. The value of log e base 2 is 1.44. So which is equal to 1.44 into s by n naught. So here c equal to 1.44 into s by n naught. So here s means the signal power, it is some constant finite value, n naught is the power spectral density of AWGN channel, right? So what is the conclusion statement is, even though the bandwidth of channel approaches to infinite, it has limited capacity, because when the bandwidth is increases, automatically the noise power is also increases, right? So that is the second conclusion. So in order to verify the second statement, we will solve one simple example, right? So to give the justification for the second point, we will solve a simple problem. So let us consider this example. So here the data is transmitted at a rate of 10 kbps, that is 10 kilobits per second. The data is transmitted at a rate of 10 kbps, that is 10 kilobits per second over a channel, right? So the bandwidth of the channel is 3 kilohertz. It is given as the bandwidth of channel is 3 kilohertz. Then determine S by N. That indicates is given as C equal to, we need to calculate the S by N value, right? The first case, that is case 1. So what is the statement is given? The value of C equal to 10 kbps, kilobits per second, and bandwidth of the channel, that is B equal to 3 kilohertz. So these are the two points is given the problem, right? Now we want to calculate S by N value. So how to calculate? We know the formula C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N base 2. So this is the formula for the channel capacity. So in this formula, we know the C value and B value, substitute C and B values and calculate S by N value, right? Now the simplification is, So C equal to 10 kbps. What do you mean by 10 kbps? 10 into 1000, that is 10,000. 10,000 bits per second, which is equal to B is 3 kilohertz. What is 3 kilohertz means? 3000 hertz. Log of 1 plus S by N based. Log of 1 plus S by N based. So here, these three zeros, these are cancelled. Okay, so left side we are having as, so bring this T to left side, so it is equal to 10 by 3 equal to log of 1 plus S by N base 2, right? 10 by 3 equal to log of 1 plus S by N base 2, right? So 10 by 3, so which is equal to the value is 10 by 3 is nothing but 3.33 equal to log of 1 plus S by N base 2. Okay, so bring this 2 to this side, so it can be further simplified as 2 power 3.33, which is equal to 1 plus S by N. Okay, so 2 power 3.33 equal to 1 plus S by N. So what is the value of 2 power 3.33? 10 equal to 1 plus S by N. Now what is the value of S by N? So which is equal to 9 equal to S by N. So the value of S by N is 9. The value of S by N is 9. That is the first case, right? That indicates the capacity is 10 kbps and the bandwidth is 3 kilohertz. If you calculate S by N value, your S by N value is 9. That is, there is no units for signal to noise ratio. Right? Now, case 2. Look at the problem once again. In case 2, if the bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz, if the bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz, then calculate S by N. If the bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz, calculate S by N. Right? The second case, in case 2, bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz. In case 2, is mentioned as bandwidth equal to 10 kilohertz, what is the signal to noise ratio, right? So already we know that C equal to 10 kbps. So use the same formula, C equal to B into log of 1 plus S by N, right? So C value is 10 kbps, which is equal to 10,000. B is 10k, that is 10 into 10 power 3, that is 10,000 log of, so remember this value is always base 2, 1 plus S by N base 2. Okay, so this one and this one get cancelled, which is equal to 1 equal to log of 1 plus S by N base 2, log of 1 plus S by N base 2. So bring these two to left side, so it will becomes 2 power 1, which is equal to 1 plus S by N. Okay, so 2 power 1 is nothing but 2. So bring this one to this side, so it is equal to 1 equal to S by N. 1 equal to S by N. Okay, in the first case, the bandwidth is 3 kilohertz, S by N value is 9. Whereas in second case, the bandwidth is 10 kilohertz, S by N value is 1. What are the conclusions from these two cases? In the first case, B equal to 3 kilohertz, S by N value is, that is, S by N value is 9. Okay? So, whereas in the second case, bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz. Bandwidth is increased to 10 kilohertz, its s by n value is 1. Its s by n value is 1. Right? So, what is the conclusion from these two points? If the bandwidth is 3 kilohertz, signal to noise ratio value is 9. Whereas, if the bandwidth is 10 kilohertz, signal to noise ratio value is 1. The conclusion statement is, if the bandwidth is increases, you can look into here carefully, if the bandwidth is increases from 3 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz, if the bandwidth is increases, signal to noise ratio is decreases. You can see carefully here, signal to noise ratio is decreases, right? That indicates the noise power is increases. If the bandwidth of channel increases means the noise power is also increases. So that is the statement of if the bandwidth is increases means the noise power is also increases, right? That is the second statement. It's clear. Infinity channel bandwidth has limited capacity. Thank you.